I believe that successful traders have tapped into an area where very few people go. I think they work harder. I think they work more consistently at it. I think they're more focused. But more importantly, I think they realize that trading, successful trading, is not about charts. It's not about fundamental analysis. It is how you think when you are in a position, be it a winning position or a losing position. And as I often say, when people are in a winning position, they have a tendency to get afraid that their position is going to turn against them. And when they are in a losing position, they have a tendency to hope that the market is going to turn around and take them out whole. But the reality is that when I'm in a winning position, I think positively about it and I add to my winning positions, i.e. I compound to make the position even bigger. But when I'm losing, I step back and say, I'm just wrong. And I think the vast majority of losing traders does exactly the opposite of how I do it. I believe that it's possible for anyone to learn to trade profitably. But I don't think the answer to profitable trading is found in the conventional way of looking at trading. I don't think you're going to take a weekend course and become profitable. You may be periodically profitable, but I define trading success as being, you don't necessarily have to be consistently profitable, because all traders go through periods where the market perhaps doesn't quite gel with your way of trading. But I think every really good trader will eventually come out ahead. And I think they do that because they have tapped into a source of approach to the market that lies far away from just technical analysis or just fundamental analysis. I don't for one second think that you can't have a mediocre form of success with technical analysis, but if you want to make big money from trading, I think you need to add a component which you can't really read your way to. And that's what tonight has been about. It's about what is that ingredient and how do you access it? They run their losses because then they don't have to accept that they're wrong. And therefore, they don't receive that jolt of pain from our brain when we have been proven, when we've been proven wrong. And as long as the position is open, as long as there's hope, it's one of the reasons why I think that the primary job of anyone who wants to make money trading is to switch around the two primers in our lives, greed and fear, or fear and hope. You see, when you are in a losing position, you're hoping. And the reality is you should be afraid that the position is going to get even worse. But instead, you know, I think you have a saying in England, in English language, saying that hope dies last. And it's so true for trading. We hold on to that belief that maybe it will come good. And it may, and it's even worse when it actually does come good, because then the next time your brain reminds you, well, the last time it worked out, just hold on a little bit longer. I have completely wiped that from my vocabulary. I think many aspiring traders start off with a naivety. And I like that naivety, because making money in the market is difficult. And I like that they come in and they think, I can do this, because you really do need that belief that you can achieve your financial goals. But unfortunately, I think the common mistake is that they go down the conventional route. So with the greatest of respect to the brokers, but the brokers are not traders. The brokers are there to facilitate a platform between the user and the market, and that's their role. But new clients or new traders, they hold on to anything that they think is going to guide them towards their goals, be it weekend courses or endless amount of webinars or books. And I've been down that route myself, of course I have, because the lack of better knowledge, what else would you turn to? But there comes a point when either you say, I can't carry on like this, either I will reinvent myself as a trader, or I'll simply stop trading, because I can't keep being on this roller coaster of making and losing. The book that I have just written and I don't want to sound commercial, but I didn't write this book for any commercial reasons. I wrote this book because I really wanted to get to the heart of profitable trading. And I felt that all the trading books that I have read, they all focused on the how do I implement this, how do I implement that strategy. It focuses on strategy, but actually strategies is just not what's going to make you the bucks. It's not what's going to bring in the dollars. It's the mindset that will bring in the dollars. Fundamental analysis. Well, look, it's difficult to talk about fundamental analysis as a tangible thing, because even within fundamental analysis, you'll have variables that can pull the market in one direction and variables that can pull the market in another direction. And quite frankly, even fundamentals can give you different scenarios depending on where you think the market is headed. So to be completely objective in the face of fundamental analysis, I'm not sure that that's achievable either. So from my point of view, if fundamental analysis means that I am reading what's going on Bloomberg or Reuters, yeah, sure, then I deploy fundamental analysis as well. I know when there's interest rate announcements, and of course I follow these things. I'm not a pure chartist. I am aware of the world around me. But I don't believe that neither technical analysis nor fundamental analysis is the reason for my success. No, I don't think I can think of a site or a book apart from the book that I've written. And again, I emphasize I am not doing this for any commercial reason, but I've already sent this book out. I have a rather large following, and so far I've sent out this book to 3,000 people. And the feedback that I get back is that people read it and it's as if a light bulb is going on in their head that actually, maybe you should spend just as much time preparing your mind for trading than you do preparing your charts. So when you're sitting there on a Monday morning ahead of the market open and you're looking at the daily chart and the weekly chart and the 5-minute chart, well, maybe you should also set time aside for some mental preparation.